Hello friends, this is Frank from Germany and I'm back and we talk a little bit about the Project X HTC. Enjoy it! So, welcome back! After 2 months, the next video session about our tool changer for the 3D printer. I was sick. I got the influenza. I think 10% of the people in Germany get the influenza. We have a big wave from this sickness. And I was, I think for 3 weeks or so, I can do nothing. And I can't do working on the project because I was so lazy and so sick, it was impossible. But now we're working on it. I improved a lot of features from our XHTC. You will see this in the next minutes. And yeah, I can say enjoy it, and please watch the video to the last 5 minutes. I have some questions and maybe somebody can help me. And but now we see some moves for the XHTC, and then I can explain how I built this and so on. Enjoy it. Some people asked me, how can I download your design? No, this is very easy. You go to my YouTube video session, season 01, episode 01. And then you see the first link is the Fusion 360 design. Click on it and then the Share It Autodesk 360 will open. You see that's a design of the X-Heat. You can change a lot in this viewer. It's just a viewer, but I want to show you some tricks here. You can go, I don't like this background image here. You can switch off. And then I don't like the colors. Mostly I take warm light and then looks really better. The rest is not so interesting. Then you can show everything, but some things I don't like. You can't hidden some things and so. Or I don't find this. I don't know. Maybe here. Oh, okay. You can say hide the objects and so on. Okay, we can try this. Let's go. This one hides object. No. Ah, okay. It's okay. So, and then you can see I changed a little bit my design. We use now 3 magnetic boards instead of 4 because it is better for the design. Also, we use on the frame holder, a little edge to put this magnetic ball holder and the tool holder from there. Oh man, my English. And okay, but this is not so important. I want to show this in the next little video session. Important is here you can download your design. And then you put your email address here and then you get an email and then you get this in step design, in Fusion 360 Archive or SketchUp or Object or what do you want? And I don't know how you can download a specific part of this design, but if I know more, then I want to tell you this. Now we are back in Fusion 360, and here you see the tool holder. It's just three magnetic boards or three washers here inside. And here, because it's better to have the correct position in every tool change from the tool holder to the magnetic holder. And also, you see here a little half pipe to slip directly here on this frame holder. We can show this frame holder here. It's not very changed, but a little bit. Here I put the hole for the screw a little bit to the outside, because now we have a little bit more place for this edge here, because my frame holders, a lot of them are broken on this point. Mostly I have a mistake with my moves on my 3D printer and so on. The magnetic holder crashed it in this frame holder, and then it's cracked here on this side. Also, I put this on the other side. You can see this now, but it's okay. And then I built here a new edge, because the solution with the two magnetics, they squeeze apart. It's not very powerful. And then, I use this edge, and it works very well. It squeezes apart the magnet holder from the tool holder, and it works very well. It's very cool. And yes, we see also here the holes for our needle rolls, and this is the place for our magnetic cubes. And works very well. I can show you this in the next minutes, printed and so on. You see this also in the video session. And this was all changes, I think. But the most important change was this this three magnetic bolts instead of four, because now the position is very good, and it works very well. I measured this with a gauge, and it's cool. So now we built the frame and the tool holders on this aluminium profile, the normal 2020 aluminium B profile. And it's not a rocket science. Now I put the frame with the tool holders on the 3D printer frame. The next step is to put the washers in the tool holder. First of all, I put them in this 3D printed part, and then I fix this with super glue. After this process, we need some very small screws, headless screws, and we put them on the front. They are made in iron, and this is for the magnetic holding process. So now we come to the software part. I use Octoprint, and I'm very satisfied with this program. This will run on a Raspberry Pi 3 on my 3D printer Hypercube, and works very well. We can put some own G-Code scripts before the tool changes happened and after them. You go to the preferences, and then you see here the entry G-Code script, and then we have two entries: before tool change and after tool change. Sorry, it's in German, because I'm a German, and yes. And then we can use a template script language. I want to explain. It's not so hard to understand. An example: we have very simple comments, if, an example, if and else and enif. And then we can set a variable with a list. And here you see 21, 101 and 191. It's the X position of my frame holders. Yeah, 21, it's the first one, but you have to count this with 0, 1 and tool change 2. So, and then here we see the feed rate. Then this is a display for the SD print. And he say before tool change, and then he make a compare from tool, a tool, it's a hash with two entries, old and new. And you see the integer number in this variables. In example, we want to change to T1, also the second tool change position. And we have a tool inside with a tool 0. And then tool old is 0 and tool new is 1. And this is not compare. And this means we can change. If then you see some moves, go to the X position to old. Y50 to old is the X position, 0 is 21. And then this is the secure position. Then he go to the secure change position. Then the move in the holder of half position, then move in the holder in the end position. Here it's a little bit complicated because 11 is my minimum Y position, and I need, I think, 1 millimeter more, but I changed a little bit the tool holder, and I think we can handle this. Yes, and then move away from holder and go to the secure position Y20. If the same, then no tool change is required. And then go to a specific position in the middle of the heat bed. This is why to go to a very secure position and start the print with a first or a second extruder. After that, it is only the first part. Now the old tool is in the holder. Now we need the second step to get the new, in our example, the new tool at position 101 or 101. And then he go, he also compare the old and new position. If not the same, then we can change the tool, or he say no tool change required. And then he go empty to the secure position of the new tool, secure change position, then move in the holder to the minimum Y position, get the tool, secure position, and so on. I want to make a short video, but very slow, then you can see every position of the tool change. I think end of this video, you will see this. Yes, and after that, you can save this. I put this also in the video description. And yes, I think it's very useful. So I changed a bit the feed rates, and then you can see first with a tool and first without a tool and then with a tool. I changed, I put the comment T1 in the console of the Octoprint, and then we see what has happened. First, he put the first tool holder in the first second, and then he want to get the tool from the second frame holder position. And yes, that's all. And you see it was very slow. And now we put this one here. No, no, this one. Let me think about it. T1 was the last one. Yeah, then we put this here in the position, and then we want to get the tool on position 0, also the first one. So, and go. I hope you can see this. And I hope you enjoy this. And next one, or next time, we want to check the electrical conditions and so on. I want to build a one extruder on this tool holder with all electrical connections. And yes, we have to patch a little bit the firmware. I hope you like it. You let me a thumbs up and you read my video description. Yes, and that's all from my side.